the statement, peace has its place, as does war. Oskar Schindler is a perfect example of peace within war. In 1939, industrialist and businessman Oskar Schindler joined the Nazi Party during the Holocaust. Upon moving into Poland, he obtained an enamelware factory, which would require just short of 2,000 employees to keep the factory running. Oskar had known that hiring Jewish people in their time of need would practically be free labor. So he created a list known as the Schindler's List. If a person was able-bodied and could manage a factory job in rough conditions, he would hire them to work and pay them by letting them keep some of the pots and pans and ammunition that they made to sell in the black market. Throughout the span of 4 to 5 years, Jewish people were hidden and saved from the Nazi Party by Schindler, who had only intended to make profit, yet learned care and compassion by the end of his life. In 1974, Schindler is dying of liver failure. He requests to be buried in Jerusalem, as he quotes, "My children are here." His request was granted and he rests on Mount Zion, Jerusalem. He had saved 1,750 people from the gas chambers. This to us is a phenomenal example as to how compassion, peace and care has a mercy has its place, as do cruelty and revenge. We see examples of cruelty and mercy every day in our lives, but the French Revolution carries a strong example of that. In 1789, a 10-year-long revolution broke out due to bankruptcy, poverty, and the mistreatment of the people. Illnesses were spreading, the homelessness rates were skyrocketing, and people were hungry like never before. The government, to try and fix the debt they were in because of their reckless spendings during the American Revolution, tried to tax the commoners more than they could spend, giving them nothing in return. The people reacted in protest, trying their best to achieve change. Over time, the votes of the people mattered a little bit more than before. Yet status determined whether or not you could vote. Moving forward, the tennis court oath was signed, where 576 out of 577 members of the Third Estate signed that they would never disband from each other without a written constitution for France. The Third Estate represented most of France, the 98%. This was a big moment for the country of France, as they finally got to stand up with power against King Louis XVI. Soon, the 98% had much more control politically in France. By the early 1790s, the people were fed up with their government. They began to burn the homes of the tax collectors to prove a violent point. Play with ideas that appealed to the 98% of France's people. A declaration was created for the people of France to ensure rights like freedom of speech. This was a step forward to equality. King Louis XVI was put on trial for his wrongdoings and oppression of the French people. King Louis XVI had failed his trial and was beheaded on January 21, 1793. After a war with Austria and Prussia, after the death of King Louis XVI, the Reign of Terror unleashed for a 10-month-long period. This was the bloodiest time of the French Revolution, as a lot of legal protection, especially public safety, was abolished. In this time period, more than 17,000 people were executed by the guillotine alone. After the Reign of Terror, the French Revolution ended and Napoleon came into power. The French people won their battle and were given the rights again to live. The French Revolution strongly represents humanity in the form of how people will react to being oppressed. People will fight back, even when they're not at their best, to ensure the rights of their people. We find people all over the world. Love has its place, as does hate. The Age of Enlightenment, tilde 1685 to 1815, in this span of 130 years, mankind found themselves more and more educated and liberal, finding a power within themselves to fight for themselves and advance in education, science and philosophy. with scientists and philosophers like John Locke, Isaac Newton, Voltaire and hundreds more. Policies within church, politics and education were changing rapidly. With people like John Locke and his philosophies, people were listening and starting to fight for their rights of freedom, protected health, right to liberties and protection against harm from others. Isaac Newton released many mathematical and scientific statements and ideas, like discovering the concept of gravity and inventing calculus. This era is crucial to what it means to be human, because if any era, it is one of the best eras to show curiosity and an interest in furthering rights and education. A lot of our modern-day society owes a lot to the Enlightenment era, as without it, we wouldn't have things like vaccines, liberalism, science and maths. This era of all shows what it means to be a human. The Age of Enlightenment is a great example of how humanity advances. Without advancement, we wouldn't truly be mankind. Love, hate, compassion, war, cruelty, and mercy all have a place in what it truly means to be human.